probably didn't employ most of the people from this neighborhood, and no one did their due diligence to find out how many people in that CVS was employed. How come they become rioters when that happened, but no one is holding the police accountable? I mean, this is just the tipping point here, what happened to Freddie Gray. See, if you do your research, you know about Anthony Madison. You also know about Trayvon Scott. You know about George Kent. I'm from Washington, D.C. I know about it. You just came here now when they started burning down stuff. That kind of shows kind of a like a agenda, doesn't it? I think calling our people fools is just a better part of the white supremacist media to show us in a negative light.
So it's okay that it's a little less expensive so we can get a white people.
Exactly. You can't really put a color to it. But when you keep brandishing one race of people and using that word, well, what are you doing? What are you doing? No one has ever white been called a thug. Never. We just saw the Sikh temple get shot up by some white men. Why didn't we call them thugs? The people that just had guns on Clive and Buzzy's ranch that was holding guns for police officers, when was the last time you called them thugs? They're not thugs, huh? It's okay. Last week, Kentucky lost, and they burned down cars in Kentucky. None of those were thugs. They were just having a good old time. Are mourning a death. That doesn't make you a thug. That doesn't make you a rioter. To me, it makes you a freedom fighter. L.E. Capital B.A.R. No problem.